Whenever you're ready, you may start.
When you hear the phrase black power, what does it mean to you?
To some, this phrase is a strong source of pride and inspired an entire generation to take action for their community. To others, this phrase is very intimidating and inspired a very strong response to quell its momentum and spread across the country. Both of these reactions are very apparent in the history of the Black Panther Party. The Black Panther Party's history is a very complex one, and to be honest, 7 minutes isn't really enough time to go over all of it. But today I'm going to do my best to explain some of the main elements to the story of the Black Panther. The reason I chose this topic for my speech is because recently, I don't know if y'all have seen the Super Bowl, but in a halftime show, Beyonce made some type of a Black Panther salute. And I wasn't really interested in the halftime show itself because the Redskins weren't in the Super Bowl, so I didn't really care. But when I saw the media response to the halftime performance, I realized that a lot of news outlets don't actually know much about the history of the Black Panther Party, and I was inspired to inform it to you guys. In order to understand the Black Panther Party, I will first discuss the founding of the Black Panther Party and its origins and the circumstances for its creation. Then I will discuss the party's ideals and platforms. And lastly, I will discuss what ultimately led to the destruction of the Black Panther. So like I said, to gain a more complete understanding of the Black Panther Party, it is essential to understand who founded the party and the circumstances that created it and the environment for which it spread. So the founders of the party were Huey P. Newton and Bobby Seale. Now, according to his biography, Huey P. Newton was born in Monroe, Louisiana in 1942. His parents had been involved in the NAACP through his church, so he had already had a strong activism background. But at a young age, his parents had moved over to Oakland, California, where he enrolled in Merritt College, where he met Bobby Seale, who he later co-founded the party. They were inspired by the self-defense doctrines of Stokely Carmichael and Malcolm X. They wanted to represent a contrast to the mainstream civil rights movement, which was, not Martin Luther King and the turn the other cheek policy. They felt that if you were to be backed into a corner, which is where the Black Panther logo comes from, they felt that if the black community, which was an analogy to the Panthers, was backed into a corner by the oppressive society of America at the time, and they felt that they had every right to defend themselves. So finally, in October of 1966, the party was officially formed. After the arrest of Huey P. Newton in 1967, that left Bobby Seale alone as the leader of the party, and he sought to expand its leadership as a result, because, you know, it's hard to run one party by itself. And he appointed Eldridge Cleaver as Minister of Information, H. Rat Brown as Minister of Justice, James Foreman as Minister of Foreign Affairs, and these, along with a few other positions, fulfilled the Central Committee of the Black Panther Party. The Black Panther Party had a plan and enacted several different programs to achieve its goals of this plan. The plan originally was the 10-point platform. The platform was officially drafted on October 15th, 1966, which was what created the Black Panther Party officially. The points were as follows: freedom and power to determine the destiny of their community, full black employment, an end to community robbery by capitalists, decent housing, decent education, free community health care, an end to police brutality, and an end to all wars of aggression. Oh, and I forgot, the unfairly incarcerated blacks, they wanted to, that was the last point, they wanted to fulfill, they wanted to free them. Now, the other Black Panther Party, or the other Black Panther Party social platforms or programs, which are most famous, would probably be the free breakfast program for children and the free health clinic program, in which the Black Panther Party at its height provided about 20,000 meals to children in the Oakland, California community. And then the health clinics provided, expanded across the United States and provided a lot of free health care to African-American communities. Finally, I will discuss, or I'm going into what actually led to their demise, unfortunately. And this was the FBI's counterintelligence program. J. Edgar Hoover was the FBI head at the time, between 1935 and 1972. He instituted the counterintelligence program to circumvent or suppress the Communist Party's rise in America, but he later expanded it to include that of the Black Panther Party. He felt that the Black Panther Party was the greatest domestic threat to national security at the time. Using this program, the FBI infiltrated the party via covert agents and informants, illegally wiretapped phones, conducted illegal raids on Black Panther offices, and distributed narcotics. Now, these are just some of the like small things that I was able to pick up on. There's a full document that was about 1,000 pages of like details on what they did specifically, and I was not going to go through all of that. So, those were the main things. They actually conducted a full-blown assassination on one of their leaders, which was Fred Hampton. He was a community leader in Chicago at the time, and they assassinated him with the pretext that he had illegally purchased weapons. And they tried to frame it that he was firing back at them, but when investigations later conducted, they found out that they were just shooting at him while he was asleep. The counterintelligence program also resulted in the other reason why the Black Panther's demise, which was the internal conflict. The FBI had posed as other members of the Black Panther Party and sent letters and other like nasty threats to other members of the party. And it officially resulted in a rift between two sections of the party. The party that was led by Elders Cleaver and the party that was led by Huey P. Newton. This was exposed in the public during an interview with the Bay Area news outlet, in which Eldridge, who at the time was in exile to Algeria, conducted an interview with Huey P. Newton, and they had a very big fallout over national television, basically. So, in conclusion, I have only managed to scratch the surface of what the Black Panther Party was truly about. However, from the party's humble beginnings in Oakland to being targeted by the United States government as a terrorist organization. And whether you agree with the Black Panther Party's message, hopefully you have a stronger understanding of what the party actually stood for today. Thank you.